But of course, Summy, where you at? Your motivation guy. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. I'm back again to bring you guys the latest and greatest tips and tricks that's going to make you the best Fortnite player you could possibly be. Settings, man, that is the word of the day. You know, with the brand new season, it's time for change. And you know what, man? Perhaps you want to step up your game a little bit so you can make the most out of your controller. So if you want to break into the world of competitive Fortnite, then you got to find the best settings that's going to help you build faster, scan the area, and aim more accurately. So let's explore some options that could really help you do just that. But before we get started, you already know what to do. You better get my favorite candy, that Bunch of Crunch, and let's get this going. Chapter 3 is a brand new start for Fortnite, man. Like, we have a new island and new mechanics to learn. For the first time since the start of Chapter 2, everybody, both noobs and pros alike, are just starting off from scratch. You know, with so much to learn, having optimized settings is gonna help you guys adjust your muscle memory and mechanics as the season progresses. This is just much better than learning these things and then just having to adjust it to a new setting. And so that's just twice the work, right? You know, for many of you that are just lured by a brand new era of Fortnite, you might be coming in from a console as you try out the game for the first time. This means that you will most likely be playing on a controller since it's, you know, usually the easiest to, you know, to play in my opinion. However, you might also be a pro, maybe looking to try out a controller, just simply adjusting your settings from the last season to the next. After all, progress cannot be made without tweaking the familiar to something new, right? So to begin, let's start off by visiting your settings and turning on the advanced sensitivity setting, all right? This is going to give you guys a few more options that you're going to need to make the most professional choices going forwards. Now, with the right settings, it should allow you to break free from the default and give you better aim, you know, your view, and actually reaction time during your Fortnite matches. So the first setting is going to be something brand new. You know, with sliding being added to the mix, we have a new setting to play around with, and that is the slide hold time. This setting determines how long you need to click your thumbstick for your slide to take effect. Due to sliding sharing the same keybind as crouching, this is one of the most important settings that you need to pay attention to if you want to make the best of this new mechanic. All right, so for slide, you want to lower it from 1.5 seconds down to 1.2 seconds. Essentially, the less delay, the better, but you know, you also don't want to find yourself sliding every time you intend to crouch. 1 to 2 seems to be that sweet spot, which is going to allow you to ease, you know, of access when it really comes to sliding on a controller, and should make it easier to nail those moments when you need to perform actions quickly. Sliding, of course, helps you travel down slopes faster, make retakes, and become a harder opponent really to hit, as you know, just rim fire your opponents. Speaking of action, why not take action towards your goal of becoming a Fortnite pro by clicking on the link below and checking out Aim Lab. Okay, so this aim of Fortnite is very aim oriented with faster movement and plenty of weapons with varied recoil. So you want your aim to be as sharp as ever so you can really take home that victory out. With Aim Lab, you can get in-depth statistics that's gonna show you how well you do in a variety of exercise routines. Even better, these routines are fully customizable so you can adjust them to your own needs and boost your skills the way you want to. One of the most important settings that you gotta start really to figure out immediately is your sensitivities. The default settings might feel a bit slow in a fast-paced game such as Fortnite, so you wanna be able to scan the area quickly and really access threats and, you know, place builds and counterattack. For this, we suggest loosening up your sensitivity until you can rotate 360 degrees quickly, but keep them stable enough so that you can position yourself correctly for an accurate shot or place in a build. If it's too loose, you're gonna find yourself speeding across the screen, and that can really be disorienting. A sweet spot for this is 40% on both horizontal and vertical, with slight variations depending on the player's preference. Keep experimenting, man, until you feel comfortable with the speed by slowly adjusting it until it feels right. However, adjusting the sensitivity won't make you a Fortnite pro overnight, guys. You also need to practice your aim using the new sense in order to really get accustomed to them. Fortnite Chapter 3 is an aiming heavy meta, with many of the weapons having recoil that requires you to have really good aim to really make the most out of it. Not only that, with weapons such as the bolt action sniper in play, being able to track your opponents from a long range becomes extremely important, so stability should definitely be on your mind. However, this is another setting that we know as ADS. ADS are your aim down sight sensitivities. When you use advanced settings, you're gonna find the option to really tinker with, you know, these and just really loosen or tighten the speed in which you move your crosshairs. This is great, guys, for especially when you wanna track your opponent and really land multiple shots consistently. Shotguns are currently in the doghouse, and you know, some of the best weapons right now are the SMG and the 7AR. And so because of this, the ADS is gonna be super important to get, especially considering the new changes to aim assist with the SMG. Oh, you haven't heard. So if you've chosen a controller to take advantage of, Aim aim assist, keep in mind that a few tweaks have definitely been made in an attempt to really balance out the new weapon pool. One such change is adjusting the aim assist so, you know, weapons are going to be impacted more by aim assist than others. If you play a match of Fortnite right now, the Stinger SMG has less aim assist. So keep in mind, man, when using your new ADS, that you are going to be switching back and forth between aim assist and a lack of. So you're going to feel a difference, man, especially this season, and you're going to need extra stability and practice to really land those shots. The best sensitivity that we see many controller players using is around 16 and 17%. Choose one and just apply it to both horizontal and vertical. Once again, experiment, just see which one feels right for you. If there's one thing that you should stay away from, guys, when it comes to ADS settings, it's having them both to be different values. If both your horizontal and vertical ADS settings are different, then your muscle memory is going to have a harder time adjusting to the difference in speeds, and it might end up just costing you a chance at a retake, a clean kill, or even the game. So what you want to do is really keep both of these settings at an equal level so there is no difference and you don't end up slipping at the wrong moment. Controller stick dead zones are unique settings to controller-based controls. Rather than having a key you press, the thumbsticks have their own sensitivity that determines how hard you need to move the stick in order to start moving forwards. Essentially, the lower you have this setting, the easier it is to trigger a movement forwards. And so with that said, guys, the last number that you want this at is 0. That just means even the slightest push forwards can really cause you to make an error in movement. The sweet spot for this tends to be between 3 and 10, and so anywhere between those numbers should really give you a good competitive setting. So if you want to be a pro, man, the best advice that we can give you is to really work on making your controls as accessible as possible. And so while the keyboard offers you plenty of options sometimes, you know, with controllers, you need to look elsewhere for those extra buttons. You know, in most cases, players are going to resort to playing claw or using paddle. In this case, we want to talk about paddles and how they benefit you in the long run. Paddles can give you up to 4 extra configuration options when it comes to your controller settings and your binds. The goal here, and I mean like right here, is to keep your thumb on the stick at all times so you can just keep moving and keep dodging your opponents. Those extra seconds of reaction time can really have an effect on you and limit how many functions you can do with a certain amount of time. So the best functions that you want to reserve for your paddles are jumping, swapping weapons, pickaxe, and edit. This season, you might also consider using one of the paddles for crouching since this is going to make it a lot easier to slide. Again, tailor your paddles, man, so that you can reach them quickly. And this is going to help you just become a speed legend so you can just react quickly to any occasion. Don't forget to check out Aim Lab after the video to find out how you can just really harness your aiming skills. You know, if there's one thing that holds true, it's that most controller players use more or less the same key binds. So what tends to really differ usually is the sensitivity. This is because, you know, no two players are the same and our reaction times and play styles tend to differ, right? You know, some players like to be speed legends in an attempt to really shake up their opponents. Meanwhile, other players try to go for consistency, you know, in builds so that they can take a slower, more methodical approach to their play style. One of the best ways to get settings that are already pro tested is to copy what the pros do. However, there are a few extra steps that you should take before doing so. First and foremost, man, you shouldn't just pick up any setting just because a player is good, right? You need to look at their playstyles and really just see which players are most like you. You know, you can do this, guys, by viewing their gameplay and watching how they act in game. And so once you find someone that you're comfortable with, you can just go ahead and experiment with their current settings. Bunch of Chris Army, where you at? Your motivation guy is back. Hope you guys enjoyed this video and really just learned a lot, man. Apply these settings to your game. I'm telling you right now, it's going to take you to the next level. If you guys liked the video, make sure you subscribe to the channel. And as I always say, man, don't ever give up on your dreams. Don't ever give up, you know, on the desires that are in your heart to make this world a better place. You can do it, man. Be a blessing to everybody you come in contact with. Hey, we'll see you on the next one. Peace.